It's not only the crop, but it's the soil also which matters. Soil inside the high tunnels have to be taken care of because soil provides nutrients to our plants. Soil provides aeration, soil harbors beneficial microbes and microorganisms that break down the complex organic matter in the soil and make it available to your plant. So the philosophy is to take care of your soil and feed your soil, which in turn will feed your plant. How can we take care of the soil inside a high tunnel? There are a number of approaches. Certainly the number one approach is to add organic matter. Organic matter can be added using compost or manure. If you're using manure, please make sure that you apply the manure in the fall and not the year when you are growing your vegetable, because manure can harbor harmful pathogens like E. coli and Listeria. Generally, we tend to use compost in high tunnels, or strictly compost when we are growing vegetables. So we try to stay away from manure. Adding compost adds organic matter, feeds the microbes, it helps the aggregate stability of the soil, and in general, it helps the plant. Other ways to add biology to your soil is to use cover crops. Cover crops are crops that are planted after or before your cash crop. So for example, you're growing tomatoes. At the end of the growing season in the fall, after you take your plants out, you can seed a cover crop. In the high tunnel situation in the fall, you can seed cereal rye, you can seed hairy vetch, you can seed some brassica crops too. And if you are planning to use a cover crop just before you plant your cash crop in the spring, you need to focus on short duration cover crops. For example, cowpea, which is a legume, which will fix atmospheric nitrogen and make it available to your plant. You can use buckwheat, you can use oilseed radish or yellow mustard. These are all short duration cover crops. And when I say short duration, they are anywhere from 40 to 50 days. So in this tunnel behind me, you can see that we have seeded cowpea. Cowpea is a legume cover crop. It adds nitrogen, and also it helps the biology of the soil, adds organic matter. So manure, compost, cover crops, and some other approaches would be to minimize tillage. I know it's hard to envision that, and because we till our soil to make sure that the soil is fine for planting and for the roots to grow in. So tillage is kind of a necessary evil. What I would suggest is till only when it is necessary. Don't over-till, because you don't want to break the complex organic matter and breaks the organic matter, because that will affect the biology of the soil. Another important factor which you have to consider when you're growing your crops inside high tunnels is crop rotation. You don't want to grow crops from the same family again and again and again in the high tunnel, because when you do that, there is a tendency for diseases and pests that are attracted to those families to stay in the high tunnel for a long amount of time. We suggest rotating our crops every 3 to 4 years outside in the field. I know it's difficult in a high tunnel because growers tend to grow tomatoes and peppers, which are the premium crops. But try to rotate it. Try to add a leafy green to the mix. Try to add a cover crop to the mix, so that helps with crop rotation. Taking care of the soil is important. We want the soil to be well aerated. We do not want the soil to be too compact. We want the soil to have a high cation exchange capacity, high water holding capacity, an ideal pH, which is anywhere from 5.8 to 6.8, and low salt concentration. When we use fertilizers inside high tunnels, year after year, gradually there is a salt buildup in the soil. Now, high tunnel is a covered space. There is no rain that falls in the soil which is inside the high tunnel. So you need to take care of the excess salt buildup. And one way to do that is to leach those salts. So at the end of the growing season or in the beginning of the growing season, you can set up some sprinklers that can leach the salt down and let them run for about 3-4 hours. So you are kind of simulating rain inside the high tunnel. And with that amount of water, when that water moves through the soil profile, it takes the salt with it. And that's a good way to reduce the amount of excess salts in your soil. And that way the salts do not interfere when the plants are growing. Because if the salt concentration of the soil is too high, it can affect the establishment and the growth of your tomato or any other cash crop. All of this will help you to produce an excellent crop. So here are the top 5 common mistakes which we see that growers make. Number 1 is the site selection. Before even you put a high tunnel, make sure you scout the site and make sure the site has good drainage, doesn't pond up.